Well, the sudden death of a Samoan worker in New Zealand last month has nothing to do with new fitness checks imposed by the Samoan government for its RSE workers. In 2 weeks' time, Samoans wanting to work under the recognised seasonal employer scheme in Australia and New Zealand will undergo fitness testing. Officials say the program's been in the pipeline for more than a year.
Last year ran the first pilot program for the test. In 2 weeks' time, we will be running the test for some 3,000 Samoans who have registered on the program. So it's not new, and for information on Sanele, it does not connect to the recent incidents of an RSC worker who died of heart attack in New Zealand.
Pacific survivors of sexual violence are among those least likely to report incidents to police. That's according to figures revealed for Rape Awareness Week. To encourage people to come forward, police have released a series of online videos explaining what happens when a sexual assault is reported. To the year ending January 2017, nearly 6,000 rape or sexual assaults were reported in New Zealand, but only 4.5% of those were pacifica. Help Auckland's Crisis Services Manager, Sylvia Yandel, says fear of shame, church and family members finding out, often prevent people from coming forward, but she insists talking to someone is critical.
Find someone you trust, find someone that, you know, you're going to be comfortable going forward with, or that, you know, you trust to talk about, and maybe they can find help so that you're not in this alone, you know, so that you're not sitting with it, you're not silenced, you're not shut down, because that just makes it worse.
Most victims were female, aged between 15 and 19, and it's likely the actual numbers are much higher, as more than 90% of sexual violence goes unreported. Well, the Labor Party has four of its five current Pacific MPs in the top 20 of its list for the upcoming general election. At number seven, the highest ranked is Kelston MP and the party's spokesperson for social development, Carmel Sepuloni. And at number 15 is Aupito Williams Seal, followed by Jenny Salesa at number 18 and Chris Fafoi at 19. Sepuloni says Pacific people are well represented in the party.
And I think it also reflects the value that the Labor Party places on the Pacific community. We've currently got five Pacific MPs, which is about 14% of our caucus, which is larger than the proportion in terms of population. And all five of us are actually in what some people call safe Labor seats. I like to say Labor-friendly seats.
Labor's fifth Pacific MP is Boto Williams, member for Christchurch East. She's at number 24 on the list. Whale conservation efforts in Niue have been given a boost by the New Zealand government. Niue conservation group Omata Fua researches the local endangered whale population and will now receive funding towards a boat charter to help with their data collection. Founder Fiafia Rex says it's a great step forward.
So Niue is at the forefront of trying to do, like, set great precedent for whale watching. And provide a VIP experience for our guests and also safety for marine mammal resources. They approved of our research because it contributes greatly towards the region anyway. Yeah, it not just benefits Niue, but it benefits the whole South Pacific region.
The group are working on the island's first whale research centre to host local and overseas students. And finally to the arts, where a new play combining African and Pacific culture is taking centre stage at the Mangere Arts Centre. In Transit tells real-life stories of Africans who migrate to New Zealand and struggle to adapt to their new home. The performances feature traditional African songs with strong Pacific performance traditions in the mix. Actor Tom Natoyalofa says he feels a strong connection with the culture.
One of the Africans who are part of the production said to me, "Don't worry about it. Africa is in you. It's part of your DNA." And I was like, "Wow, thank you." And that's what's been driving me through the whole process.
The play runs until next Saturday. And that's your Pacific News. Back to you, Marama.
Thank you very much, Seinafolava. I had to crack up at Tom's comment about being African there. Anyway, the ninth World Masters Games wrapped up here in Auckland last weekend and has been heralded as the most successful games yet. Now, there are no country delegations, so basically if you want to turn up and say you're representing Tuvalu, you could. All qualification requirements, sounds like I should have entered. You just need to be over 30 and have a winning attitude. Ana Ulika Rumafai, I caught up with some of our Pacific athletes for this story.
Auckland was home to the ninth edition of the World's Masters Games last month, and being home also to the world's largest Pacific population, you didn't have to look far to find one in action. Over 27,000 athletes competed over 28 sports, and it was swimming that drew one of the largest numbers of individual competitors, including Melanie Kotinen, Niue's only swimmer.
The flag doesn't show up on the scoreboard, so that makes people really curious about where Niue is. And so a few people have said, where is NIU? And so it's just, I've given them a bit of a, geography lessons and things like that.
Melanie hasn't swum competitively since high school and started training again just 4 months ago. But here at the Games, there's no qualification requirements, just a thirst for participation.
So what I think is just really awesome is seeing people who are like you, who are still wanting to be sporty but are still getting older, and everyone's just participating and having a really nice time. And so it's not stressful, it's just really relaxing and everyone's encouraging.
And who better to illustrate the spirit of the Games than endurance athlete Tangaloa Michael Stowers, who competed in 10 events including track, road cycling and cross country.
So today's triathlon, a little bit tired today. Even though I'm not in the medal count, I still say I'm first Samoan finisher. So I'm here, just giving it a go, representing Pacific.
As some would say, finishing is winning. There's plenty of room for everyone, no matter your circumstances.
And if I can do 10 events, and I've been 105 kilos, no one's got an excuse. I was watching the 90 and 85-year-olds doing the long jump. They just do half a metre run, so jump, and it's awesome.
There weren't many Pacific athletes to be found in these hostile weather conditions, but on the other side of town, it was a very different story. Over in East Auckland, the rugby events featured more than a few Pacific faces, most notably the Northwestern Allies, who won the final of the 30-plus category.
I'm really stoked because it was a bit of hard work getting it together, especially when they required the registration fee. So everyone was pretty keen, but once they got the registration fee, we ended up getting about 28 of us together.
And while the scoreboard showed they perhaps belong more in Super Rugby than the Masters Games, it's all about the camaraderie at the end of the day.
There's a number of guys I played school rugby with, and there were a whole bunch of mutual friends and different relationships. Everyone's connected, and the rugby community is actually quite good like that. So if anything, it's just building relationships or reconnecting again, and it's such a wonderful thing to see.
The event finally came to a close after 10 days of action, but not before one important announcement.
You have made the World Masters Games 2017 the best games ever.
Auckland certainly made this year a tough act to follow, but there's always room for a few more Pacific athletes.
I think that it's in us. I think that there's speed and there's natural abilities, because I haven't had formal training, but I think that it's right there, So, I think that it would be awesome to see more Pacific Islanders here, and I think we'd probably clean up more,